Are you watching this video on a monitor or in a smartphone? There is over 50% probability that your answer is gonna be a smartphone, since in recent years over 50% of web traffic has been generated by mobile devices. This means that half of the people who visit your website will be viewing it not like this, but like this. And it makes up for certain challenges for the designer, such as the necessity to create device-specific layouts, where you will need to change the order and positioning and sometimes even the contents of your sections so the scale of each element is appropriate for a specific device. This means that your grid has to adjust to the width of the device screen. The best solution to that is reducing the number of columns your layout has when on tablet devices, or placing your sections in one column when viewed on a smartphone. But as a result, you might end up with some pretty lengthy pages. In some cases, it is recommended that you get rid of some sections to benefit your mobile layout. By using a heat map, you can determine which sections on your site evoke the most interest and just remove the rest from the mobile layout. Another tip to reduce the length of your website is, instead of putting elements of the same type in a list, or in a grid, throw them together in a carousel, so users can view them by scrolling through the carousel and then move on to exploring the rest of your layout. As for the navigation, you want to make sure that you hide all the extra stuff you have in your header inside of a neat hamburger menu. If it's a store, a blog, a news portal, or a site with booking functionality, make sure you include the search icon in your header or inside the hamburger menu, so users can find what they want straight away. If you need to place a primary CTA somewhere on your page, there's no better place than the hero section. So it's right in the user's view once they open the page, and they're able to perform this action straight away. Another option could be placing it in the header if you have enough room in there. Now, text. Picking a wrong font size can seriously compromise readability, so the text elements on your mobile layout should be 12 to 16 pixels for the main body copy, and 1 or 2 pixels smaller for secondary elements, such as captions and tags, while your H1s should be 2.5 size of your base font. Headings should fit on 2 to 3 lines on average, so it doesn't take up half of the user's screen. As for the clickable interactive elements such as buttons and fields, make sure that their size is bigger than the average touch target, which is 10 by 10 mm. And talking about interactive elements, if you embed a form, make sure you don't make it too long and too confusing. Go for a form which can fit in the screen dimensions and has a comprehensible and friendly UI. Websites with some heavyweight functionality, like online stores for example, also require a lot of UI elements to be present on the pages, so don't dismiss mobile users' need to access all of those filters, buttons, and options, but do let these elements breathe and organize them in a way that is not intrusive and confusing, but comfortable and intuitive to use. Well, it was pretty much it for this brief beginner's guide to designing mobile website layouts. And if you're a web designer, developer, or site owner yourself, you might be interested in what TemplateMonster Marketplace has to offer in terms of responsive website templates, e-commerce templates, and WordPress themes, and also other assets for website building, such as plugins, illustrations, fonts, and much more. Make sure to follow the link in the description to explore TemplateMonster Marketplace yourself. Well, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, leave us a like and subscribe to our channel. You could also drop a line in the comments regarding what else you would like to learn about. See ya!